Thank you so much and good evening. We are thrilled to be here. We are thrilled to be sharing these stories and polkas tonight. And we really hope you'll enjoy this program, whether you are here in this theater or attending virtually through our website. Thank you so much for joining us. We are all struggling. We are all struggling with the raging pandemic that has now been going on for over 2 years. And the world is at war. The war in Ukraine is tearing at many of our hearts. Previously this spring, there was a benefit concert to benefit displaced Ukrainian musicians here at the Music Hall, and I believe it was a sold-out concert. And so what we would like to do tonight is to donate our half of the 50-50 raffle, which we'll do at intermission, to that fund. There's information about that fund on the inside cover of your program, if you'd like to read more about it and follow that website. And so we felt it was appropriate, and we are going to open this evening with both the Ukrainian national anthem and the Stars Spangled Banner. So would you, if you would, please stand. Thank you. This performance this evening is dedicated to our longtime friend and supporter, Edward J. Herko. The band and our greater community music mourn his passing. Tonight is about his story and about all of our stories. Some of them are fantastic, some of them are mythological, and some of them are just just a pleasure to relay. We're starting tonight with a piece by Rossano Galante, his Sword of the Titans. And this is very, very cinematic in nature. It sort of seems to tell the story of the gods struggling and using their swords to do battle. At one point, it seems like we go to the Sahara Desert. I can see Peter O'Toole going across the desert. Yeah, you know what I mean. So we hope you'll enjoy this opener. Rossano Galante, Sword of the Titans.
Thank you.
So 10 years ago, in 2012, we invited Technical Staff Sergeant Joseph Bello as our guest soloist, and he performed three works for Euphonium and Band. Now in 2022, I'm excited to bring to the stage Dr. Joseph Bello, who has just finished his DMA in conducting at Northwestern University and will begin his tenure as the interim director of bands at Tahlequah, Oklahoma at the University of Northeast Oklahoma. So here to present and conduct Rest by Frank Tekeli, please welcome Joseph Bello.
Thank you.
So I especially want to greet the virtual audience that is here with us today. And since a lot of our audience has had a chance to greet each other and get to know each other by name, we'd like to take a minute. If everybody that's virtual on YouTube right now could just, if you could just open your microphone and just introduce yourselves right now, that would just be great. Go ahead. There, that's it. Yeah. Good. Wow, there are a lot of Johns that are watching tonight. Great, thank you. And if you are watching tonight, we are doing these web streams free of charge. If you are so moved and you're enjoying the music tonight, please hit that PayPal button. Throw us $20 for the cost of a ticket. We would really appreciate it toward the costs that we have incurring toward these productions. The next story that we are telling or relating in music is by Harrison J. Collins. He's still in college. He wrote this piece when he was 17 years old. And I think you're really going to be impressed once you hear how beautiful and how complex this is. The Paper Man is based on a recurring dream he had as a child. And the name The Paper Man will become evident once we get going. And it's something that you'll see, especially in addition to hearing. So here's Harrison J. Collins, The Paper Man. So I know a lot of you are wondering, what's the accordion gonna sound like? And I think you're gonna be incredibly surprised. We first got to know Matt Pod 8 years ago when we started playing at the Caramore Festival for the 4th of July concert. And Matt initially was the arranger of the vocal selections that were a part of that festival performance. And over the years, I learned to know Matt a little bit better and learned that he has a twin brother, learned that he lives in Brooklyn and also plays piano and has a small ensemble that plays in clubs and bars. He's also conducted the show Hadestown on Broadway. He's produced this album with his twin brother, a 33 RPM, isn't this cool? Yeah. And he's a phenomenal accordion player. And so this has been on my bucket list for a number of years, not only to have him join us to play, but to have our wonderful arranger, Barton Green, write the arrangements for him. Yes, Barton Green. And my last bucket item has been the chance to conduct Piazzolla, this incredible Argentinian composer who wrote the most incredible tangos. He went to the French Conservatory to learn to write classical music, and he just ended up being told, you know, you're really good at tangos. You just need to stay with tangos. And so we are opening this first with Oblivion by Piazzolla, and then for a completely different change of pace, Tico Tico, which has a joy and a life all its own. So we are so excited to play these two numbers for you. Please welcome to the stage the accordionist Matt Pod.
Before we begin, I just have to say a quick word about why I have two accordions for two songs. It's mostly to prove to my wife that I do need to own two accordions. She's watching in the live stream, so. But in all seriousness, they're just two different instruments with some different timbre, and Barton, the fabulous arranger, has brought a lot of different qualities out of these different songs, and it warranted a different sound. So I'd like to just give a round of applause to Barton for the arrangement on that last piece.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. As we announced earlier, we're selling 50-50 raffle tickets. Our half of the 50-50 is going to go to the Displaced Ukrainians Musicians Fund. We hope that you will want to be a part of that. We'll see you in 15 minutes. Thank you very, very much. So our next story really has to do with taking a wonderful cruise, a post-pandemic cruise. And we've been trying to play this piece for 4 years. And one thing or another, having to do with the pandemic or something else, just kept getting in the way. I first learned about Josh Idio and this piece because of the group of graduate students who created the website called And We Were Heard, a website devoted to promoting underrepresented composers, composers of color, female composers, LGBT composers. And so we signed on with that, and we were matched with Josh. And we were supposed to play this in May of 2020, yes. And so things kept getting canceled, and we kept pushing it back, and Josh transferred schools, and he went to Montclair State, and just recently he won the Montclair State most outstanding graduate composer, that's it. Outstanding graduate composer at Montclair State University. So that's a really, really wonderful honor. So I'm going to invite Josh to the stage, and he's going to introduce his piece. Here is Josh Idio.
Hi, everyone. Good evening. First, I want to thank Director Ebersol and the Westchester Symphonic Winds for a wonderful half of the concert already, and for giving me the opportunity to hear this piece performed live for you tonight. The Cruise Line Dream is my first ever composition for wind band, written back in 2011, and was only just published a few years ago, actually. And that's because it was my test to see if I could become a composer. So back in high school, I went on this great band trip to Italy to perform some music by another great composer, who I also got to meet, Frank Tichelli, yeah, the composer of Rest. And I got to meet him as well, so that experience really inspired me to give the composition world a try. And so as I was trying to figure out what kind of story I wanted to write for my first piece, I found myself staring at a picture of me and my family on a Disney cruise, of all things. I don't know why I didn't think of Italy, but a Disney cruise. And so I thought to myself, yeah, a cruise could work. And since then, since 2011, this piece has only grown. So what you're about to hear is the culmination of 4 to 5 years of early independent studying as a young composer. And thanks to this piece, I found that I really do love composing. So I hope you enjoy. I hope you're able to immerse yourself in my story of 5 years of experience and also my time at a cruise. But also, as the summer gets closer and we're able to go back out and have fun, I hope you're able to immerse yourself in your own story, maybe a dream of your own cruise. So I hope you enjoy. This is the world premiere of the Cruise Line Dream.
Thank you. Thank you.
If I don't say this, I'll be in deep water. Hi, Mom. She and her friends are watching from the Masonic Village in Elizabethtown, Pennsylvania. We're so grateful to the Tarrytown Music Hall crew, in particular, all of the staff and crew that have made this possible tonight, for making these web streams possible. We are really, really very fortunate to be able to do that. Thank you very, very much. So we're entering the polka section of the evening. Yes, yes, we've got some polka fans. There's an extra charge if you dance in the aisles. Just rein it in. This extraordinary polka and fugue is from a little-known opera that has just seen a revival in Berlin called Schwanda the Bagpiper. And this piece was transcribed from the original orchestra by Glenn Cliff Bainham. Glenn Cliff Bainham was the first director of bands at Northwestern. He was the teacher of my teacher, John P. Painter. So the storyline here is that this has trickled down through the generations and landed at my feet. And this is one of those grand finale pieces that every band should play at some point. And you're going to hear what we're talking about when we get to that point. So this is Polka and Fugue from Schwanda the Bagpiper by Jaromir Weinberger. Thank you.
Thank you. So we have a raffle, and I think the raffle's coming up. And Josh, do you want to pick the number? So this raffle raised $1,000. We'll be donating $500 to the Displaced Ukrainian Musicians Fund, and the winner of the other $500 belongs to someone with a yellow ticket. I know, that narrows it down, right? 570-677. Thank you for the house lights. 677. 570-677. Yes? 570-677. Oh, near miss. Still looking for 570-677. You have 676? Looking for 570-677. Band? Does anybody in the band have it? 570-677. No. Okay. 570-677 going once, going twice, and we're going to pick another number, Josh. You can cut the tension with a knife. Okay, now we have a salmon ticket. And the number on the salmon ticket is 109037. 109037. Oh, come on. Everyone around the world is watching this. Yes? Yes? Is that it? Oh, Kathy Davis, our principal horn. Kathy is the band director at White Plains High School, so I couldn't be happier for Kathy. So we promised you more than one polka. Matt Pod is back. Probably the most famous polka ever written is a clarinet polka. So we're going to close with this. Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in and for being a part of this with us tonight. Here's the clarinet polka.